of both. Do you have a song that we haven't played yet that you like?
No.
I asked you. You
said
it.
She likes You Break My Heart.
You Break My Heart.
Aww.
Another song that
my
nice partner does not play. Just a small correction for the future. You're not a Milk Carton Kids fan, you're a Kenneth Patton fan. Yeah.
Go.
Oh, hey Jason. I could hear Joey playing guitar through the monitor. You break my heart into so many pieces. You break my heart like nobody does. You break my heart in all the right places. Then again, you break it some more. You break my heart as if you meant to. Now I know there's no way you'd know how you'd break my heart. Then take my heart, then break my heart for good.
Us if we would sing harmonies on this record that he's just finished, and it's beautiful, and we went and did it, and it came out great. And so when we started going on tour together, we were like, oh, we, you know, let's do that song for everybody in the encore. So this is Charlie Hickey tune called Nikita.
Change.
did I fucking kill him? Did he ever told anybody? I never meant to make you cry, but I guess I thought that I was a good guy. And when they said I was all talk, well, yes, they were right, 'cause I lied.
Thank you so much for being here. Yeah. Don't forget, go over and get some merch before you leave. It's true, Joey did let me produce this album, which was, I was about to say the greatest highlight of my career, but well, one of the greatest highlights of my career really was. And it changed a little bit of the way that we work after 13 years together. And not because I had any more power or any like decision making or anything, but that it just changed the way that he and I could roll up our sleeves and access each other's emotions and access each other's intentions. And so the last year and a half, 2 years now has been, I think, the most fulfilling writing that we've ever done. It's our favorite record. It's one that feels like the most consistent and shared artistic vision that we've tried to do together in a decade. And at the end of that process, we got through 10 songs and then we hit a brick wall. But we wanted 11 songs. Like, not that we were fixated on the number 11 or anything, but just that the 10 songs didn't quite tell this whole story and there was something left to say. And for months we tried writing another song and nothing was coming, so we
we stooped to this thing we call folk roulette. We write a bunch of random verses and then you smash them together to see if anything good happens or anything cool happens, which is a terrible and shameful thing to do when you're trying to make art. Not art, when you're just trying to finish a record that's so personal for us, for it to happen that randomly and stupidly felt awful. But so one day we were in the studio doing the Milk Carton Kids Mad Libs. And I was in the control room working on the computer, and I sent Joey as his boss and overlord to the other room to write more words, and he came back and I said, "What have you got?" And he said, "Well, I wrote an entirely different song." And he played me the song, and it was one of the most beautiful Joey Ryan songs I've ever heard. And we broke for lunch and we recorded it three times, and the second time we recorded it is what you'll hear on that album if you take it out the door with you. And we're going to finish this evening with you. We can't wait to come back to Cleveland. And I hope that when we do that, you'll be here as well.
Because the song is so new that I was like, how is that possible? And then I was like, well, I guess it's been out for a few months, and so somebody could have learned it by then. And then I was like, what's the quickest I've ever learned a song? And by that time, it was time for the next line to happen. But I wasn't there.
Do you think it was a real person, or do you think the ghost of the Beachland Ballroom came out of here?
I think it was the ghost of Grog. Okay, so tell him the whole story again and then we'll start.
To be honest, you were a little distracted when we started, too. Yeah, this song. Remember when it started and you were supposed to sing and then we kind of just went around the merry-go-round a few more times?
I was thinking, I wonder if anyone knows this song.
Yeah! It's called Leaving the Car Door Open.
You kiss my hand, leaned over, said, twice a day, even broken clocks bound to be right. I followed you inside, watched as you turned out the light. I'd never loved anyone so bad, I'd put up a fight. You're always forgetting everything you've done in your life.
I thought the line was about me.
You say I won't remember this morning by the night. But I remember you smiling at me one time in a rising moonlight. I never saw anything wider or told myself you could still hear me somehow in your dreams. I whispered I love you, I'm sorry, and I think you know. Running through the night.